hours travel.
Sorry, one?
1 hour and 30 minutes travel from airplane.
Yeah.
Davao and Manila is very far. It's north to south.
Yes.
From Davao to Bohol, it's 1 hour travel.
By plane?
By plane.
I think the word or vocabulary in Philippines same in Indonesia.
Similar, yes.
Yeah, similar.
Like the numbers,
yeah,
in my in my place. Davao,
yeah.
The language is Bisaya, and Bisaya looks like Bahasa.
Bisaya?
My language is Bisaya.
Oh, different with Tagalog?
Yes, it's different from Tagalog.
Oh.
So, our numbers are similar with Bahasa?
Yes.
Isa, duha, tulu, upat, desyo.
Itiru.
Similar.
Similar.
Okay.
Yeah. I read your address is Rambutan Street. Yes, right.
Yes, yes. Rambutan is
Rambutan fruit. Is yeah, fruit, tropical fruit in
in Indonesia. It's
yes,
also
same.
The same. It's
yes,
Rambutan.
Same. Yes, same. Rambutan.
And durian, the famous durian.
Philippines, there are arimas.
Hi, rambutan arimas. There is rambutan in the Philippines. In my place, a lot of rambutan here.
Oh.
And then.
Kangkung.
Anak.
Coronano ato.
Kangkung.
Oh, anak, yeah.
Kangkung is a vegetable, right?
Kangkung? Yes, right. Yes, right.
The same.
Same.
So if I'm going to go to Indonesia, I will be using Cebuano, Bisaya language.
Oh.
Bisaya.
Bisaya.
My
bahasa daerah gitu.
Agung gofung gofung ato de hajimemasu. Gofung ato de.
It's interesting. We have similar words, kotoba.
Yes.
What else?
Anak.
Selamat.
Selamat. Salamat. Salamat is arigato. Thank
yes.
you in our language.
Demo imi wa betsu desu. Selamat.
Betsu.
Selamat.
Yes.
Selamat pagi. Selamat malam. Evening.
Pagi in Philippines, in our dialect, in our language, it is an animal. Pagi.
Oh. Pagi.
It's an animal.
What animal?
That is a stingray.
Oh.
Pagi is stingray.
Stingray.
Umoshiroi. It's interesting.
And they get say ni mo aku
oh. One of fish stingray.
Yes.
Oh, interesting. But in Indonesia we call pari.
Pari.
Pari?
Yeah.
Pari?
Pari.
Pari.
The meat. In Bisaya it means priest.
Oh.
Priest.
Priest.
In the church.
Oh.
Pari. Pari.
Pari is mean same with pagi.
Pari is priest in our language. It's a person, it's a person.
Yes, 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 yes.
Dekpong, link gare ba share shimas. Gakse wa mate maskara.
Diba diba ngalek.
So if you will be going to Philippines soon with Dekpong, I can tour you in our place, Davao.
Oh, yes, of course.
The place of the Philippine president is Davao.
Oh, really?
Yes. And president...
Sorry, the name president is... I forget.
Duterte.
Duterte, president yes. of Philippines.
A friend of Joko Widodo.
Oh.
We are good friends.
Oh, yeah.
I think Joko have been to was he? I don't say Joko have been to Davao City or just in Manila.
Oh really?
Joko Widodo.
Joko Widodo, yeah, is our president. Oh, sorry, sorry, not our. Me.
Why? The Indonesian president.
Yes, the Indonesian president.
From your place, is that far from Jakarta?
Yeah, by plane is 1 hour.
Oh, it's far.
Yeah, we different island. Actually, I live in Kalimantan, you know, Borneo.
Near Borneo?
No, I live in Borneo.
Borneo?
Yeah, West Borneo.
Oh.
Yeah. We have five big island. Indonesia is Sumatra, Java, Borneo, Sulawesi, and then Papua.
But you are near to Singapore, right?
Not really.
Where's that place near to Singapore?
Sumatra.
Ah, Sumatra.
Yeah, Sumatra.
You can go there by ship, I think. By ship. From Singapore.
Yeah. From Singapore to Indonesia by ferry.
By ferry, yes.
Yeah, the island name is Batam.
Oh.
The island is Batam Island. The province name is Riau Islands. And then by ferry only, I think 20 minutes or 30 minutes.
So it's very near.
Yeah, it's very near.
When you go to Singapore, can you understand their language, Bahasa, as well?
Sometimes English, sometimes Melayu, because Malay. Sometimes we use English, sometimes we use Malay, because Malay is similar with Bahasa.
Bahasa. Oh.
Yes.
So you can understand Malaysian language.
Yes, Malaysian. Where is Nasya? Pong?
The nearest to our language is Bahasa, at the same time, Spanish. Because they also use Spanish.
Yeah,
there's a place in Philippines, Zamboanga, near Indonesia. The nearest place is in Indonesia, that is the Zamboanga city. They speak Spanish.
Oh. Full Spanish.
Yeah, Spanish plus Tagalog. They mix it.
Hello, welcome back.
Or we have Desi, Desi Ari. Selamat pagi.
Hai, Hajime Masyo. Hajime Masyo, ka.
Yes, shall we start? Onegai ne link, onegai.
Hai, hai, mate ne. Mo no seta yo WhatsApp de.
Ah, WhatsApp de. Hi, copy shimasu. I will copy it.
Hai, ohayou gozaimasu, minasan. Gambarimashou.
Gambarimasu. Good luck.
Hai, dozo, ne, Mr. Ahmad, dimulai.
Oh, udah.
Nah, mau juji yo. Sudah jam 7.
Jam 7?
Jam 7. Jam 10. Jam 7. Mr. Ahmad.
Ya.
Ahmad,
wait. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi semuanya, salam sejahtera bagi kita semuanya. Magandang umaga to our special guest, Jose.
Magandang umaga.
Magandang umaga. Ohayo to Nasya. Ya, pagi ini kita akan webinar terkait dengan JLPT or Japanese Language Proficiency Test dengan narasumber Ibu Rahajeng Nastya Sekarhayu, SPD, MPD, dan juga nanti dilanjutkan dengan Jose Mary. Sorry, your name is difficult.
Dari
Elmindo Ordinary LPT PhD.
Hai.
Okay, untuk mempersingkat waktu, yang pertama saya persilakan kepada Ibu Rajeng Nastya Sekarhayu, SPD, MPD untuk mempresentasikan terkait dengan JLPT. Okay, time is yours.
Hajime Masyo, pertama-tama saya akan menjelaskan mengenai sebentar ya, dibukain dulu ini. Hai. Webinar JLPT seri 1. Jadi dalam webinar kali ini saya dan Mr. Jose, Mary akan menjelaskan mengenai JLPT series itu seperti apa, apalagi untuk kalian pemula yang notabene memulai N5 dan N4. Nah, di webinar kali ini materi yang ingin saya sampaikan adalah ini. Nah, di sini bisa dilihat Sebentar ya. Coding si mas. Hai, hiragana. Kenapa saya menekankan bahwa kalian itu harus mempelajari hiragana? Karena notabene hiragana ini adalah huruf keramat, bisa dikatakan seperti itu. Kenapa huruf keramat? Karena hiragana lebih sering dipakai daripada katakana dalam banyak hal, dalam bacaan, dalam kita lihat di mana-mana itu kebanyakan yang dipakai adalah hiragana daripada katakana frekuensinya, karena memang penggunaannya berbeda tujuan. Katakana untuk penyerap kosakata serapan dari bahasa N5 harus dan paham betul cara penggunaan hiragana dan huruf-hurufnya itu dihafal betul dalam waktu 2 minggu. Ini maksimal ya. Untuk caranya saya sudah share banyak, pakai aplikasi inilah, pakai inilah. Nah, itu tolong dipergunakan. Kemudian lanjut ke langkah-langkah bagaimana sih kita itu untuk bisa ngehack JLPT itu pasti lulus dalam waktu misalnya target untuk JLPT N5 misalnya 2 bulan. Nah, kemudian 2 bulan kemudiannya nambah ke JLPT N4 gitu. Jadi sekali tes itu kalian bisa masuk langsung ambil JLPT N4, karena sejatinya tes JLPT itu tidak harus urut dari N5 dulu lulus baru lanjut ke N4, enggak. Tapi misalnya kalian sudah memiliki kemampuan N4, bisa langsung ke N4. Nah, pertama tadi ya, hafal huruf hiragana. Dan nilai plus jika hafal huruf katakana. Gitu. Jadi memang harus seimbang sih. Gitu. Kemudian kanji hack. Nah, masalah kanji ini saya sudah tekankan dan saya sudah upload video ya per babnya. Kalau untuk anak N5, oke lah, satu kali satu hari itu menghafalkan untuk 10 kosakata atau 10 kanji per babnya untuk 8 kali bab. Nah, kemudian untuk yang N4 ditambah lagi satu harinya 20 kanji seperti itu. Kemudian hafalkan kotoba-kotobanya. Pasti ini kalau lihat list-list itu kan aduh bosan sekali, banyak sekali, belum lagi tulisannya pun kita masih belajar kan masuk yang pertama-pertama, baru anak N5, baru anak N4, pasti baru mempelajari mengenai hafal-hafal kotoba ini. Nah, tapi ada kok caranya yang enak. Kemudian jangan lupa pakai Japanese keyboard. Jadi semakin sering kalian itu menemui huruf-huruf hiragana, huruf-huruf kanji, apalagi ketika ngetik, kalian tidak pakai romaji lagi, tapi pakai hurufnya hiragana katakana atau bahkan bisa pakai kanji, kalian akan terbiasa dan ketika mengerjakan soal lebih mudah. Kemudian untuk pola kalimat, nah ini kalau saya mengajarkan pasti saya akan bandingkan pola kalimat satu dengan pola kalimat satunya. Jadi dua buah pola kalimat ini miripnya di mana, nah penggunaannya seperti apa. Nah, bolehnya pakai kata kerja atau kata sifat atau kata benda. Nah, itu saya part-partkan, saya rangkum. Dan biasanya saya akan upload di YouTube saya, di playlist yang pola kalimat JLPT N5 atau JLPT N4 atau bahkan JLPT N2. Begitu ya. Nah, kemudian drill latihan soal. Nah, ini untuk anak-anak online saya, pasti sangat paham. Saya ada kelas online dan itu free, gratis. Tapi kalau misalnya menggunakan Zoom yang one by one, memang ada berbayar. Tapi yang untuk di WA dan saya share soal-soal melalui Google Form itu gratis. Tolong dikerjakan dengan baik. Misalnya satu minggu sekali ini ada soal listening lah. Kan JLPT ini ada soal-soalnya, ada sebenarnya ada 3 bagian kan. Bagian pertama itu GOI atau vocabulary, kemudian bagian keduanya itu bungpo dan dokai, reading ya sama grammar, kemudian bagian ketiganya listening atau chokai, mendengarkan. Nah, itu saya selalu share, itu kerjakan, Rek. Jadi ketika kalian mengerjakan, oh paham ya kali soal-soalnya JLPT itu seperti ini tipenya, seperti itu. Oke, kalau sudah paham nih langkah-langkahnya, kita masuk ke kanji. Nah, kemarin kan banyak sekali yang, aduh kanji ini susah, udah hiragana kata. Tes tulis ya. Jadi kalian tidak harus menghafalkan sedikit-sedikit sekali. Kita sering-sering baca saja, itu pun sudah bisa untuk ngehack soal JLPT atau kalian bisa lulus JLPT yang kalian inginkan. Nah, di sini ada aplikasi GPro. Di sini ada Minano. Minano ini sesuai bukunya ya. Ada vocabulary, grammar. Ini bisa dihafalkan. Nah, kemarin juga ada anak N4 yang tanya, Bu Nasya, ini kalau jidosi, tadosi itu seperti apa gitu kan? Membedakannya. Nah, di sini ada nih. Ini aplikasi GPro. Nanti akan saya share di link di bawah ini ya. Nanti. Oke. Sampai di mana tadi? Kok hilang? Hilang kah? Halo? Sampai di mana tadi? Tuh, maaf ya, kok bisa sih? Oke, pelan-pelan aja ya kalau gitu. Berarti belum semua kah? Kok bisa sih? Jatuh temati, jatuh temati. Oh, aplikasi Jipro. Thank you ya. Nge-lag mungkin. Padahal saya ya ini, jelasin tadi. Jipro. Oke. Bentar, bentar saya searching lagi. Berarti dia nggak bisa lama ya. Baiklah. Maaf ya. Oke lah, nggak apa-apa. Aplikasi Jipro ini ya. Jadi ada aplikasi Jipro dan ada aplikasi... Langsung saya zoom aja ya, biar nggak hilang lagi. Sorry. Nah, ini ada aplikasi Jipro. Kayak gini. Ini ada bisa pakai buku Minano, ada semua di Jipro ini. Minano 2, Minano 1, misalnya nggak punya buku, pakai ini oke. Kemudian ada Show Matome, itu ada juga di sini, Show N3 sama N2. Ada kanji-kanji juga. Kemudian kalau kanji studi ini sudah saya jelaskan ya, ada videonya juga. Untuk N5 kalian belajar 80 kanji, jadi per babnya itu 10 kanji. Jadi otomatis kalau semakin sering dipelajari, 2 minggu saja sudah hafal ini ya. Kemudian yang N4 juga. N4-nya 166 kanji, jadi memang saya tambah per babnya 20 bab. Baik, kemudian kotoba. Nah, di sini caranya hafal kotoba itu seperti apa? Yang pertama itu main game dengan aplikasi. Kalau kalian terbiasa main game, 2 jam, tolong seperempat jamnya atau setengah jamnya dibuat main game dengan aplikasi. Kemudian, sering-sering nonton anime. Terus, kalau nggak gitu, film Jepang agar terbiasa dengan kosakatanya, kotobanya, gitu ya. Sesuaikan selera saja kalau masalah filmnya. Kemudian aplikasi yang direkomendasikan ada di sini JLPT GOI. Munculkan dia saya ya? Nggak berbayar, nggak aman. Kalau yang JLPT GOI ini gratis, Jipro gratis, Kanji Studi dia upgrade-nya. Sampai langkah-langkah sensei. Oh iya, arigato Rofika-san. Email dasang, oh enggak berbayar, aman. Kemudian, ada yang ditanyakan lagi kah? Hai. Oke. Okay. Maaf ya. Nge-lag. Baik. Nah, kemudian ada setelah aplikasi, kalian harus memahami pola kalimatnya. Beli buku, kalau misalnya masih hemat, ya udah ikutin kelas online. Nah, kalau kelas online ya resikonya di kuota. Ada kelas online yang gratis, ada kelas online yang berbayar. Nah, ini tergantung biasanya kalau berbayar sih. Kalau saya yang itu ya, yang one by one, yang satu persatu gitu, tatap muka. Kalau yang online gratis, ya ini untuk semuanya. Gini gratis, nggak apa-apa. Gitu. Yang kedua, identifikasi pola kalimat yang dikhususkan setiap level. Jadi, misalnya kalian nih belajarnya JLPT N5, kan itu udah ada daftar kosakata tuh. Biasanya, saya akan membatasi atau membandingkan dua buah pola kalimat ini mirip, bedanya di mana. Itu lebih efektif loh. Jadi, kalau kalian lihat video saya, misalnya mitai dan yo, pola kalimat dua ini mirip, nah bedanya di mana? Nah, semakin sering kita belajar seperti itu, maka kita semakin gampang menghafal pola kalimatnya itu. Baik, selanjutnya pelajari dan buat kalimat dengan kosakata yang telah dipelajari. Jadi kalau misalnya belajar pola kalimat, ya udah kita masukkan, oh kosakata kemarin gara-gara hafalan di JRPT GOI ini ada muncul di pola kalimat yang kita buat. Nah, dengan demikian kita terbiasa untuk apalagi untuk JLPT N5 ya, untuk dasar itu sering-sering buat kalimat lah, nanti pasti cepat bisa, gitu. Ini pengalaman saja, ada mahasiswa saya, dia itu dari nol, dia satu bulan saja bisa lulus CLPTN 4? Kok bisa gitu kan? Oke, sampai ke materi tadi dulu ya. Ini Mr. Ahmad ingin menyampaikan sesuatu, silakan.
Teman-teman semuanya, mungkin ada gangguan internet di Ibu Nasya ya, ada gangguan jaringan. Jadi nanti untuk pertanyaan-pertanyaan silahkan dituliskan saja di live chatnya, di live chat di YouTube bisa diketik di situ. Untuk pertanyaan-pertanyaan nanti kita kumpulkan dulu pertanyaan-pertanyaannya, nanti baru dijawab oleh Ibu Nasya.
Ya,
jadi nanti untuk pertanyaan-pertanyaan nanti dikumpulkan aja dulu atau diketik dulu di live chatnya, nanti baru nanti dijawab oleh Ibu Nasya. Mungkin sebelum Ibu Nasya memulai lagi, saya tadi ada sedikit kelupaan terkait dengan CV dari Ibu Nasya.
Nanti saja nggak apa-apa.
Karena ini udah buatnya udah semalaman, jadi harus di. Oh nanti juga di. Oke, sip. Oke, silakan Ibu Nasya, boleh dilanjutkan lagi terkait dengan materinya.
Jadi pas saya tanya jawab nanti bisa diperkenalkan gitu ya. Saya jawab udah.
Oke, sip.
Hai. Oke, saya remove dulu ya Pak Mai. Oke. Maaf ya. Sebenarnya internetnya tuh oke, cuman kadang ya kayak gitu. Saya coba bukan. Oke lah. Baik, ini kurang sedikit kok materinya. Yang selanjutnya adalah masalah scoring JLPT. Ini banyak sekali yang tanya ke saya mengenai scoring JLPT, ya kan? Yang pertama kita pahami dulu pembagian skornya. Kan ada tiga bagian tadi. Yang pertama itu ada GOI atau vocabulary atau kosakata. Kemudian yang kedua, bagian kedua adalah grammar dan reading, yaitu tata bahasa dan doka ya, dan bacaan, membaca gitu kan, kalimat yang panjang-panjang, paragraf dan lain sebagainya. Kemudian bagian yang ketiga adalah listening atau cokai. Nah, listening ini mendengarkan ya, kita ada play, kemudian kita menjawab sesuai dengan yang kita dengarkan. Nah, kemudian ada batas kelulusan atau PG, passing grade. Nah, berapa sih batas kelulusan kalau untuk N5 dan N4, gitu kan? Habis ini saya share gambarnya. Kemudian, yang ketiga adalah ikuti alurnya. Nah, nih. Table JLPT N4. Terlihatkah? Baik. Terlihat ya? Sorry. Nah, di sini ada level yang N4 dan N5. Nah, nilai seluruhnya itu 0 sampai 180. Jadi saya kan selalu nih jumlahkan antara bagian 1, 2, 3. Kalau bagian 3 bagian itu jumlahnya itu bisa 90 poin untuk N4 ya. Berarti kalian lulus gitu. Tapi lihat juga di setiap sesi, jadi di 3 bagian itu, tiap bagian itu di atasnya sekainya kalian 60 misalnya sempurna. Kemudian readingnya, dokainya juga 60. Nah, ternyata vocabulary-nya cuman 10. Jadi nilai totalnya 60, 60 kan 120 tuh. 120 ditambah 10, 130. Harusnya nih lulus di atas 90. Tapi karena satu sesinya di bawah 19 poin, maka otomatis kalian tidak lulus. Ini untuk N4 ya. Kemudian untuk N5. Nah, kalau untuk N5, poinnya lebih rendah, 80 poin ya untuk ininya, batasannya, passing grade-nya. Tapi di tiap sesinya sama, minimal adalah 19 poin. Gitu ya. Kemudian lanjut ke, nah, contoh-contoh kalimatnya, contoh-contoh mondainya di JLPT itu seperti ini. Hai, say and, nah, ini, sorry. Nah, kalau mondai ICI, dia, kalau ini yang JLPT N4 ya, jadi ada kanji, kemudian cara baca kanjinya. Nah, ini kan mirip-mirip, say and, say nen, sen and, sen nen, gitu kan. Yang betul adalah yang nomor 3. Sen eng des. Nah, caranya gitu. Kemudian mode kedua, tipe soalnya pasti seperti ini. Cara bacanya dulu, kita disuruh cari kanji yang cocok sama kuci ini yang mana. Nah, 1, 2, 3, atau 4. Biasanya kanjinya tuh mirip-mirip kayak gini. Nah, pasti kalau misalnya nggak begitu hafal kan bingung nih, antara 1 sama 4 nih, kok sama. Cuman satunya ada double, satunya enggak. Jadi yang benar yang Ichiban. Kayak gitu ya. Kemudian, mode yang ketiga. Ini contoh soal N4 ya. Mode ketiga di GOI seperti ini. Jadi ada, nah, nani-nani ini, ni nani yo iremasu ka? Ichi, ni, san, yon, kara, ichiban, i, mono, hitatsu, erande, kudasai. Jadi, re-nya kayak gini, zasi, kak, nah ini, masukkan. Yang benar tuh yang mana? Kalau zasi atau majalah, itu satuannya apa? Ada satsuka, atau maika, atau daika, atau hikika. Nah, yang paling benar ini, ichi, dimasukkan. Kalau mai kan biasanya kan untuk sara atau apa lembar gitu kan. Nah, ini yang dimaksud kosa kata goinya tuh ini. Kemudian mandai yongnya ada, nah, kalau ada soal kayak gini, berarti lihat re-nya, lihat soalnya, misalnya nih, ni nen mai ni Kyoto e ikimashita. Nah, artinya apa? Kita artikan dulu ke bahasa Indonesia. Ni nen mai ni Kyoto e ikimashita, berarti 2 tahun yang lalu pergi ke Kyoto. Nah, yang sama yang mana nih? 1, 2, atau 3, gitu kan? Nah, ini sebenarnya ada satu lagi lah ini. Ada yang Yongbang itu, hey, 2 tahun lalu gitu. Jadi yang benar yang Yongbang. Sungiwa mondai yang 5. Nah, kalau mondai yang 5 ini ada satu kosakata, cocoknya itu dipakai yang mana? Gitu, dipilih 1. Bakari maska. Baik, silakan kalau ada pertanyaan. Mulai sekarang saya hanya menerima beberapa pertanyaan ya. Nanti misal sisanya bisa by lainnya. Baik, dozo. Sensei.
Oke, terima kasih. Baik, Pak Mai. Bisa Ibu Nasya. Oke, Oke, terima kasih Bu Nasya atas presentasinya yang sangat menarik sekali terkait dengan tadi JLPT dan juga tips dan triknya bagaimana bisa lulus JLPT. Mungkin di sini ada teman-teman yang masih awam sekali atau masih yang baru sekali terkait dengan JLPT. Apa sih itu JLPT dan sebagainya? Jadi JLPT itu atau Japanese Language Proficiency Test itu untuk sebagai syarat kalau kita mau kuliah di Jepang atau sebagai syarat kita mau kerja di Jepang. Jadi semacam TOEFL untuk dalam versi Jepangnya seperti itu. Benar Bu Nasya ya? Jadi banyak sekali pertanyaan tadi di live chat Bu Nasya. Sepertinya kita lanjut ke materi selanjutnya. Baru nanti pertanyaan dikumpulkan dulu ya. Sabar ya teman-teman ya. Sebelum kita lanjut ke materi selanjutnya, mungkin ada yang belum kenal. Kan ada pepatah istilah, ada pepatah yang mengatakan kalau tak kenal maka tak sayang ya. Tapi kalau udah sayang mau gimana lagi ya. Jadi Ibu Nasya ini lahir di Bojonegoro 8 Juli 90. Beliau lulusan dari S1 dan S2 Pendidikan Bahasa Jepang di Universitas Negeri Surabaya. Beliau juga mengajar, sekarang mengajar di UPN sebagai dosen. Dan juga beliau salah satu alumni dari Japanese
Language Institute.
Japanese Language Institute Urawa di Tokyo. Oke. Atau mau dijawab sekarang Bu Nasya? Atau mau nanti aja di terakhir?
Boleh sekarang kayaknya, nanti kan beda.
Oke. Oke, jadi beberapa pertanyaan banyak sekali di live comment dan di live chat. Saya bacakan aja. Pertanyaan seperti
aja, Pak. Satu saya jawab.
Berbayarkah aplikasinya ini? Tadi sebenarnya sudah dijelaskan. Terus terkait dengan bagaimana cara menjawab soal berbintang, Sensei, dari Billy Andanu.
Oke, Billy Sang yang berbintang nanti bagiannya Jomar Sensei ya. Ini masih vocabulary, jadi ada lima macam mondai. Jadi satu sesi yang vocabulary ini ada lima macam mondai.
Oke, terus ada pertanyaan lagi dari Syafiq Adnan. Sensei, JLPT pakai sistem pengurangan nilai nggak ya? Misal kalau kita salah satu poin atau nggak jawab, dikurangin satu poin.
JLPT tidak ada pengurangan nilai, jadi kalau bisa diisi semuanya saja. Gitu. Tapi ya jangan asal cap cip cup, kembang kucup, ngitung kancing, tetap hafalkan, tetap pelajari ya. Hai.
Oke, lanjut ya. Dari Via Lestari, Sensei, Sumomasen mau tanya dong, Sensei. Nanti kan kita CS JLPT-nya berbasis komputer atau bagaimana, Sensei? Dan supaya kita ini benar-benar bisa paham cukai dan dokai, bagaimana?
Cukai. Hai, JLPT itu memang berbasis komputer di ininya ya, di screeningnya, jadi untuk penilaiannya di lembar jawabannya. Cuman kita ngerjakannya pakai ini kok, pakai pensil, bukan kayak tes CPNS, tes kedinasan yang langsung by komputer langsung muncul nilainya, begitu tidak. Tapi mengisi di lembar jawaban dengan menggunakan pensil 2B. Dan supaya kita benar-benar bisa paham cokai dan dokai, bagaimana? Nah, kalau cokai, saya rasa kalau kalian sering-sering nonton anime, nonton film, itu sangat membantu untuk pendengarannya ya. Jadi ketika orang Jepang asli yang ngomong, kalian tuh paham speednya mereka ngomong gitu loh. Kalau untuk yang masih baru-baru, saya sarankan sih ke anime ya, kayak misalnya ke Detektif Conan kah, Doraemon kah, yang bahasa Jepang loh ya, bukan yang Indonesia. Oke, Sunyi?
Oke, terima kasih Sensei. Tadi benar sekali tipsnya terkait dengan kalau misalkan kita paham, kalau kita pengen paham terkait dengan cokai, belajar dari menonton film. Terus ada lagi pertanyaan dari Chris Mandala. Kapan saatnya menggunakan onyomi dan kapan saat menggunakan kunyomi? Itu sensei. Halo? Apakah mendengar, sensei?
Hai, hai. Jadi onyomi dan kunyomi ya. Kalau onyomi itu dia gampangnya saja dia itu bertemu dengan kanji lain. Contohnya yasui atau murah, kanji yasui ini kanjinya murah. Nah, dia kalau sendiri itu dia kunyomi gitu. Artinya murah. Nah, kemudian kalau onyominya itu dia yasui sama ketemu dengan misalnya anzeng gitu, anzeng gitu, kayak dua buah. Kayak misalnya Manabu, logonya webinar kali ini kan Manabu tuh belajar kan, Manabimas. Nah, Manabimas itu logo webinar ini. Nah, itu kalau ketemu dengan kanjinya lahir, kelahiran umareru, yang kunyomi umareru, maka akan menjadi gakusei. Jadi gakse itu lahir dan belajar. Artinya kayak gitu, jadi onyomi. Hai, Sugiwa.
Oke. Dua pertanyaan lagi saya bacakan, nanti untuk yang lainnya mungkin nanti bisa langsung ke private atau langsung ke konsultasi online dengan Ibu Nasya. Saya pilih dulu dua pertanyaan. Oh, ini dari Asep Prihatna. Maaf melenceng, perkenalan singkat, tapi nggak terlalu singkat tapi dalam bahasa ya, Jepang. Saat interview di perusahaan, bagaimana sensei?
Ya, yang penting menyebutkan nama, kemudian menyebutkan lulusan mana ya, kalau interview perusahaan tuh lulusan mana gitu. Terus kamu itu passionnya di apa gitu, singkat, padat, dan menarik. Hai, Sumi.
Oke, terakhir dari Malik Albu Gisi. Sensei, kalau bedanya JLPT dengan tes bahasa Jepang lain seperti Nates dan lain apa ya?
Bedanya adalah begini, Nates itu ada yang levelnya tentu saja ada yang setara dengan JLPTN berapa gitu kan ya, kemudian JFT, kemudian JTES juga. Pasti setara dengan beberapa level, misalnya kayak JFT basic, dia setara dengan JLPTN 4. Tapi bedanya adalah kenapa saya itu kayak fokusnya tuh mending ke JLPT gitu, karena JLPT itu benar-benar yang paling diakui gitu loh, yang paling apa ya, untuk perusahaan dan juga yang paling recommended itu JLPT. Untuk kalian lanjut misalnya kuliah juga JLPT. Kemudian untuk kalian yang misalnya ini sekarang perawat kah atau teknisi kah atau jurusan dari teknik pertanian dan lain sebagainya, itu memang paling oke JLPT gitu loh. Kalau punya JLPT itu udah oke gitu loh. Memang kayak Nates, JFT juga ada yang setara gitu loh. Hai, sudah.
Oke, terima kasih Ibu Nasya atas sharingnya atau pengalamannya terkait dengan JLPT. Mungkin ada beberapa pertanyaan yang belum bisa dijawab atau belum bisa saya bacakan di sesi ini, mungkin bisa langsung ditanyakan ke konsultasi online melalui Ibu Nasya. Oke, untuk mempersingkat waktu, kita lanjut ke materi selanjutnya terkait dengan Hello Jose.
Hello, yes.
Hello, selamat pagi, Magadong Maga. Before we start the your presentation, I will explain your CV.
Ah, yes.
Yes, mungkin di sini banyak sekali yang belum mengenal terkait dengan Jose. Jadi, nama lengkapnya, his full name is Jose Mary Elmindo Ordinaria LPT PhD. Dia tinggal di Rambutan Street, San Roque Village Delio, Torre Davao City, correct?
Yes.
Yes. Bagi kalian yang ingin kontak numbernya, if you want to save the phone number, the phone number is +639 66221 7529. He interests to teach biological science, qualitative and quantitative research, applied linguistic and Japanese language. His background is postgraduate PS, sorry, bachelor of secondary education major in biological science, a Japanese school. Graduate of Master of Art in Education, major in Science Education, St. Mary College of Tagum, and postgraduate PhD in Education, major in Applied Linguistics in University of Immaculate Conception. Okay, I think you can start your presentation, and time is yours.
Salamat pagi, at terima kasih Ahmad, Mr. Ahmad. Salamat pagi.
Yes.
Okay, I'll be presenting now. My presentation.
Yes.
For N4. Can you see my screen?
Not yet.
Not yet. How about this one? This one. Can you see now my screen?
Not yet.
Not yet. Kana. Okay, I'll be stuck. Okay. Share audio. Okay. Now, can you see now my screen? Sensei, can you see now my screen?
Not yet, not yet. I have your presentation. I think I will share screen your presentation. Wait.
Okay. How? I am clicking now. Share screen. Share. So I'm now starting to share my screen. Is my screen now visible?
No.
Not yet. Wait. It is visible now here in my screen. Is it visible already?
Okay, yeah, ready.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, this one.
Yes. Okay, you can start.
Once again, salamat pagi from Philippines to Indonesia. Magandang umaga sa inyong lahat. I will be presenting to you and Yong Gengochki Bumpo Dokai. A while ago, Nasya Sensei presented to you about GLPT and Yong and the nature of N4. So this morning, I will be explaining somehow what would be the content of Bumpo and some drills for Bumpo and then Dokai. Okay? So again, I will be your presenter, Jose Mary Ordinaria PhD from the Philippines. So once again, salamat pagi, magandang umaga. So, as you can see on the first question from this part, Bumpo Dokai, Kino no shukudai wa suku nakatta no de blank owarimashita. So, what should be the answer for number one? Okay, of course, number one is not. Let's have the choices. Erante kudasai. So let's choose the answer. For number one, nijupun, it's incorrect. Number two, nijupun shika, it's incorrect because if you are going to use shika, the verb should be in negative form. Owarimasen. Number four, nijupun o, it's also incorrect because o is not used together with a time, and 20 minutes is an absolute time. So number three is the answer, nijupun de. Okay, that's number three. So that the sentence would be kino no shukudai wa sukunakatta no de nijupun de owarimashita. Okay, let's have number two. Kono robotto wa shito blank kaiwa suru koto ga dekimasu. So we have two entities here, the robot and the person, roboto and shito, or human or a person. So number one, ya, is incorrect. Number two as well is incorrect. Number three, e, is incorrect. So the best particle for this, because talking about to, number four, to in English, that is and or together with. So the best answer for this question is number four. So it is kono roboto wa shito to kaiwa suru koto ga dekimasu. Okay, number three, ototo wa kisai toki yoku keiga shite ryoshin blank shimpai sasemashita. Okay, it's a tricky one. So what could be the answer? Number one, it is not correct because that is not the particle that here is inappropriate for the sentence. Number three is also incorrect because you cannot use no as a possession for ryoshin and then the verb shimpai sasemasu. Number four as well is incorrect because ya is used for many examples. So the best answer for this is number two. Oh, okay. A technique for this kind of problem in GLPT and Yung is that you have to delete those, for example, in this case, delete the particles which are inappropriate so that you can arrive with correct answer. Yung, hotelu no asagohan no pan ga totemo oishikatta no de. So, yotsu tabemashita. So we have here the choices. Number one, mo, two, ni, three, ga, four, de. Number two, ni, is incorrect. We cannot use that one if there is a counter for objects. Number three as well is not because we have the verb tabemas. And then four, de, is also incorrect for the sentence because we have a counter before the verb. So the best part of this, the best example for this problem is number one, mo. So you have eaten four or eight at least of bread, okay, in the hotel. The answer is mo. So when there is a particle or when there is a counter for objects like that, and then the verb looks like, or the verb can be tabemashita or nomemashita, so you use mo for this case, okay? Let's have number five, gobang. Kono nihongo no jisho wa 150 nen mai ni gaikokujin blank tsukaremashita. So we have here the choices. We have kara o ni tsuite, which is all about, and then ni yotte, accordingly. So let's delete some of those which are not appropriate in the sentence. Number one, kara is not appropriate. Number two as well is not appropriate. Number three is incorrect. So the best here is ni yotte. Okay? So kono nihongo no jisho. So this Nihongo dictionary that is 150 years before. So the foreigners are using it. So that's ni yotte. Number six. Eishi no undo jo wa blank tsukaimasu ga yoyaku ga hitsuyou desu. So in that case, this is a tricky one. So we have dare demo, dare o, dare ni, dare ga. Let's delete some of those which are inappropriate. Dare o, it's incorrect. Dare ni is also incorrect because there is no addressee. And then number four, dare ga, it's also incorrect. So the best answer for this problem is dare demo tsukaimasu ga. So anyone can use. Okay? Dare demo. Number seven, maeda. Ri-san, itsumo blank kuni no kazoku ni renraku shimasu ka? So if that is the problem, so let's have the answer. Ri, meru o kaku koto ga oi desu. So what's the answer for this problem? We have the choices. Dono gurai, dono, doyatte, do iu. So ri-san, itsumo blanku ni no kazoku ni renraku shimasu ka? So the answer, meru o kaku koto ga oi desu. So that is in English, I am writing many mails. So how do you, for that problem, how do you communicate with your family? So that how do you in Japanese is number three, doyatte. Okay, doyatte. So that is, this doyatte is also in English means how. How do you, in what way, okay? Hachibang. Musume wa, okay? Musumi wa, sengetsu koukou wo sotsugyo shimashita. Blank, daigaku no nyugakushiki desu. So, dandan, it's gradually, it's incorrect. Amari is also incorrect because there is no negative word in the sentence. Daitai is also incorrect. And what is appropriate in this sentence is that after the graduation in high school, what should be the next part of the sentence? He or she enrolled, musume. She enrolled directly to the college. So that is number four. Mousugu daigaku no nyugaku shiki desu. So that is number four is the answer. Mousugu. Kyuban. Esa wa eki ni iku basu ga blank konakatta no de takushi de ikimashita. So it is a long sentence, right? So this morning at the Eki, at the station, I go to the station. Or there is a bus going to the Eki or to the station. So blank konakatta no de, it didn't come. So takushi de ikimashita. So I ride a taxi. So the answer is nakanaka. Number two. So yatto kitto itsuka is inappropriate in the sentence. So nakanaka means For that note, I ride a taxi because there is no bus available going to station. So nakanaka, that is appropriate in the sentence. Okay? Number 10. It's a long dialogue, okay? Yamashita. Minami-san, ashita ka asatte karaoke ni ikanai? So, would you like to go for a karaoke on tomorrow or the other day? So, Minami answered, ah, iine, ashita wa tsugo ga warui kedo. So, she's not vacant tomorrow. So, asatte blank daijobu dayo, daijobu dayo. So, what could be the best choice for this problem? Any guess? So, if this is the case, if there is a decision to be created, so the best that you can use is number 4, nara. That means if. Okay, so if. So, asatte nara, daijobu dayo. If it is the other day, the next day around, so I am okay. So, nara is appropriate for this case. Nanoni is, it cannot be used nanoni here. Dakara as well, because dakara means because. Demo as well, but you cannot also use in this sentence. So, nara is the appropriate one. Okay? So, number 11. Watashi wa blank aida supa de arubaito o shite imashita. So, the choices are the following. We have natsuyasumi ni, natsuyasumi de, natsuyasumi no, natsuyasumi. Because we have here aida, that's in between, so we cannot use natsuyasumi ni aida, natsuyasumi de aida, and natsuyasumi aida. But we use aida here with a noun, so we have to use the particle no. So the best example here, the best choice here for number 11 is natsuyasumi no aida. So there should be a no particle linking to aida in this case. That's number 11. The answer is number 3. Okay? For number 12 problem, senshu niwa no ki no eda o kirimashita. Zenbu blank ni jikan kakaremashita. So, what should be the answer for this case? So, kitari cannot be used because that is not composed of sequential sentence or many examples in a sentence. So, kitari, number 1 is incorrect. Number 3, kirini, incorrect. Because, of course, we have here another verb, kakarimashita. Number 4 is also incorrect. Kirukado ka. Nijikan kakarimashita is also incorrect because, of course, this is a fixed one, an absolute one, an absolute time. So, number 2 is the best answer. Kiru no ni. So, even if, no ni is even if in English. So, even if you have Zenbu kiru no ni nijikan kakarimashita. So kahit even if you have cut that one, you have cut those trees and branches, so it took you still 2 hours to do that. So it's kiru no ni. Number 13, Kimura. Yamada-san, ashita no gogo saka no renshu ni ikimasu ka? Yamada. Ikimasu. Demo, gozenchu ni yoji ga aru no de blank. So the choices are quite long. So number 1, let's delete some of those inappropriate in the sentence. Number one, ukurenai de kudasai. Ukurenai de kudasai is incorrect. So, ukurenai de kudasai means don't be late. Ukurenai. Number two, okurenai hoga i. It's also incorrect because it's better to be late. Oh, good to be late. Number two, that is the meaning of number two. Number four, ukurete wa ikemasen. So you don't need to. You don't have to be late. So the best choice for this is number three, okurera kamo shiremasen. So I might be late. Yan. I might be late, number three. So, because I have some things to do in the morning, with entire morning. So, number three is the appropriate answer for this problem in number 13. Okureru kamo shiremasen or okureru kamo shirenai. Number 14. Okay. If you have questions later, I'll attend that. Questions, okay, I'll attend to number 14. Yes. Shokudo de, that is the setting, it is in the cafeteria. So mori aite iru seki ga arimasen ne, so there is no vacant seats. Tanaka demo asoko no seki ga blank yo, so I think in that place or on over there is a vacant seat. Mori, honto desu ne? Yes, there is. It's really. Aku made sukoshi machimashou. So, what could be the best choice for this problem? So, let's delete some of those inappropriate choices. So, number two, akimashita yo. Number two is incorrect because it is already conclusive that there is vacant. Okay, number four, ai tayo des. This pattern is also inappropriate with the sentence. Number three, ai te imas. Yes, the ai te imas could be somehow, however, you are certain on the vacant or the availability of the seat. Instead, you can answer number one, akiso desu, meaning to say it seems to, it might be, so you're not so sure if there is. So in this case, the best choice for the problem is number one, akiso desu yo. Number one is the correct answer. Take note, if you're not so sure with the conclusion, if you're not so sure with your answer, in the sentence pattern of Japanese, you can use so desu. Okay, so desu. Number 15, kaigi shitsu de, at the meeting place, conference hall. Conference hall. Hayashi. Ueda-san, kaigi no junbi wa owaremashita ka? Tetsudai mashou ka? So are you done with the preparation for the meeting? May I help you? So Ueda, arigatou gozaimasu. Thank you very much. Ja, isu ga hitotsu tarinai no de, tonari no kaigishitsu kara blank. So it's the chair is not, it's only one and it's not enough for us to have. So the answer of Hayashi, hai, wakaremashita. So the blank there is the kaigishitsu kara blank. So what should be the answer? Okay, let's delete some of those inappropriate choices. Motte konakute mo ii desu. It's inappropriate because they need to have one chair or we need to have another chair. So number three is incorrect. Motte konai to ikemasen ka. Number four as well is incorrect. Motte kite imasen ka. So the appropriate choice for this problem should be motte kite moraimasu ka. So in the problem, tonari no kaigishitsu kara motte kite moraimasu ka, or can I have one chair? from the other conference room. So this number two is the correct answer. Number 16, Jurok Subang. Senggetsu Made. So if it is Senggetsu, so that is past month. Hanaya ga atta blank 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 oishi desu. So what should be the answer for this problem? So let's again decide as to what would be the best choice. So number two, ringo no keiki ga oishi desu. Is that correct? How about kisaten wa oishii desu? Of course, it is not. Atta kisaten wa oishii desu. Basho ni oishii desu. It's incorrect. So, the correct answer for this is in number 16. So, number 2. Ringo no keiki ga oishii desu. So atta ringo no keiki, that's apple cake, ga oishii desu. Okay? Number 7. It's dekita. In this case, we cannot atta dekita oishii desu. So in this case, okay. Dekita is the answer for this case. Dekita makes the sentence incorrect for this case. Sengetsu made hanaya ga atta dekita oishii desu. Chotto matte ne. I would consult first the kotaisho for this problem. It is in the kotaisho of number 16 is ichibang, das dekita. But if you're going to analyze the sentence, senggetsu made hanaya ga atta. So hanaya is a flower shop. Hanaya is a flower shop. So ringo no keiki is not under hanaya. So, the best answer for this is, in this case, it's number one. Gomene, it's number one. Dekita. Okay? Number 17. So, number 17, kino no yoru. So, yesterday night, ie ni kaete kara kagi o blank oboete imasen. So, what could be the best answer for this? Kaigi o doko, doko oboite, it's incorrect. More so, if it is kagi ni, kagi o ni, it's incorrect. Kagi o ka, it's incorrect. So, since that we have the particle o in the problem, so the next should be a verb. So, that is oita. Oita oboite imasen. So number 2 is the correct answer for number 17. So number 18. Watashi wa piano o blank chikan ga arimasen. So for this case, because we have let's have the choices. Piano hiku no ga chikan ga arimasen. It's incorrect. It's inappropriate in the sentence. Number 2, piano o hiku jikan ga arimasen. It can be, however, it's not still the best answer for that problem. Let's have number four. Piano o skides ga. So it is also it is incorrect because the particle beside piano is o. And then the next, if we are going to use number four, suki, ski is an adjective. So o is inappropriate for that. So the best exam, the best answer for this number 18 problem is sangbang saikin isogashikute chikanga arimasen. So I was very busy recently, so I don't have any time for that. So number three is the answer for number 18. So number 19. So again, a trick for the for this part in Bumbo Dokai in JLPT, you just decide as to which is not appropriate in the choices for the sentence to make it correct. Okay, number 19, watashiwa nijisai no tanjoubi, gomen, tanjoubi ni sofu ga blank imasu. So, watashiwa nijisai no tanjoubi ni sofu, so 20th birthday. What should be the answer for this case? Kureta, incorrect for this sentence. Kureta imasu. It's incorrect. We also have tsukatte imasu. It's also incorrect, inappropriate in the sentence. Kamera o imasu. It's also inappropriate. So the best answer for this is taisetsu ni imasu. Since that there is a particle ni in taisetsu that links to the verb imasu, that makes it correct. Taisetsu ni imasu. Number 19. So tofu is very important in the 20th birth in my third 20th birthday. So that is number one. Okay. Number 20. Hayashi. Raishu. Okay. Ya raishu. Yakyu no shi'ai o mi ni ikou to omotte irun desu ga. Ri-san mo isshō ni dou desu ka? Ri-san e? Yakyu no shi'ai desu ka? Ii desu ne. Blank desu. So what should be the best answer for this problem, for this scenario? So number one, let's delete which are not appropriate. Number one, zehi ikitai desu. It's incorrect. Number two, koto ga nai desu. Ii desu ne. Koto ga nai desu. It's also incorrect. Number three, mini itta desu. It's also incorrect. Number four, no de. In this case, that is in number 20, the answer in the kotai show is no de. No de desu. Des no de desu. Des. Des ne. No de desu. So, in this case, the answer for number 20 is no de. Might be that in, on the star, the no de is placed on the star. And then there is a there are words before the node that could make the sentence correct. So in this case, the answer is number four, node. Okay. Because you cannot answer because number one, Hayashi invites Ri to go to the Yakyu Shi'ai. And then Ri also responded to that invitation, but he cannot use zehi ikitai desu. Zehi. Okay? So the answer here is number four, no de. Now, let's have for the larger paragraph for the selection. So, mondai san. So, this is sui-e. Sui-e means swimming. So, watashi no, okay, let me read the selection part. Watashi no shumi wa sui-e desu. send shoe, my shoe every week. My shoe puru de oyoi de imasu. So number 21. Hantoshimai made wa oyogu koto ga dekimasen deshita. Nihon ni kuru mai ni sunde ita tokoro ni wa umi mo puru mo nakata no desu. So hantoshimai natsu yasumi ni nihonjin no tomodachi to umi ni ikimashita. Tomodachi wa toku made oyoide ikimashita. Keredomo, so but watashi wa watashi blank oyogemasen deshita. Tomodachi ga kakoyokatta no de watashi mo oyoide mitai to omoimashita. Tsugi no okay, tsugi no shi kara machi no puru de oyogu renshu o hajimemashita. Suie no jouzu na tomodachi ni oyogikatta o blank muzukashikatta desu ga maishu tomodachi to renshu shimashita. Sore de sukoshi zutsu blank ima wa hitori de renshu shite imasu. Oyogu no wa totemo tanoshii desu. Tsugi ni umi ni iku made ni takusan. Okay. Blank. There is a strategy for this. If you're going to answer this kind of long selection, go directly to the question and go back to the selection. So if you're going to read first the problem, to read the choices for number 21. So number 21 choices, we have sore ni dahara shikashi tatoeba. So when you go back to the problem, 21 is located there. It is in the first sentence. So what should be inserted in number 21? So sore ni dahara shikashi tatoeba. Take note that we have a negative. We have a negative word dekimasen deshita. The appropriate word to be partnered with the negative one, to the negative word is shikashi, because that is the only but in the in the choices. Sore ni dakara tatoeba are for addition. Shikashi is the negative but. So the answer is shikashi. Okay? So number 22. Wa nara demo yori. Let's go back to the problem. So watashi blank oyogemasen deshita. So the best answer here is cannot use yori, demo, and nara. So we have the answer here. The best answer for number 22 is wa. Watashi wa oyogemasen deshita. I cannot swim. So watashi wa oyogemasen deshita. Oyogemasen is a potential verb which means cannot swim. And if that case, who can do the verb? It is watashi. So watashi is the subject. Therefore, our particle here should be wa. Okay, to highlight the subject watashi. Next, number 23. So we have the choices. So number 23 is located on that side. Sui e no jouzu na tomodachi ni oyogikatta o blank. So since that we have here the word tomodachi ni oyogikatta from my friend, sui e no jouzu na tomodachi ni oyogikatta. So from my friend, from a friend who is very skillful in swimming, so let's choose the best choices, or the best, let's choose the best answer for from the choices. So number 23 is oshete imashita. It's incorrect. Oshete kuremashita is also incorrect, because of course you have received training from your friend who is good in swimming. So if that is the case, the best answer is oshete moraimashita. Oshete morau, I received training from my friend who is good in swimming. So number 4 is the best answer. Oshete agemasu is to give. Okay. So number four is the best answer for this problem. Oshete moraimashita. Number 24. So number 24 is there. So muzukashi kata desu ga, even if it is it's difficult, but every week my friend and I do practice is practicing. Sore de sukoshi zutsu. Sukoshi zutsu means a little by little. So the best answer for number 24 is number sukoshi zutsu oyogeru you ni narimashita. So that is number 2. So I swim like this. Slowly I learn to swim this one. To learn how to swim. So that is number 2. Oyogeru you ni narimashita is the appropriate answer for this choice. Number 2 is the correct answer. Number 25. So that is found in the last sentence. Tsugi ni umi ni ikumade ni taksang blank. So next, at the ocean or at the seas. So the answer, the appropriate answer for this problem is number 3. Renshitai desu. So you want to practice, or in the choices. So number in number 25, tsugi ni umi ni ikumade ni taksang renshitai desu. So the person wants to practice more. Okay. Once shitai. Number 3 is the appropriate answer for this problem. Okay. So now let's have the reading. It's just the first part of the reading. So let's have the next. Okay. So wasure mono ga arimashita. So I have a thing that was left or forgotten. So wasuretashito wa sensei tachi no heya e tori ni kitte kudasai. So this is an announcement, so a lost and found announcement. So that is number 1, jisho. And then we have also boushi, a hat and a dictionary. So when was that? So December 5. Okay, so now let's have the choices. So you go directly first to the problem so that you can go back to the choices or to the selection given. So, shiken chuu no mikakan ni wasuremono o tori ikitai shito wa doushi nakereba narimasen ka? So that is the case. So it was 3 days, around 3 days of the exam. So now, let's have the choices. First, shiken ga owaru made machimasu. Sensei tachi no heya e tori ni ikimasu. Wasuremono ga atta basho e tori ni ikimasu. Kyoshitsu de jibun no kurasu no sensei ni hanashimasu. So, what should be the appropriate answer for this problem? So, where do you want to get the thing that was found? So number 4, kyoshitsu de jibun no kurasu no sensei ni hanashimasu. Or where do you report if a thing was lost? Okay, so in that case, the choices, the best choice here could be number 4, at the classroom, in your own class, you talk to your teacher. So number 4 is the best answer. So where can we see this number 4 situation from the given text? So it is found here at the last portion. Kyoshitsu de kurasu no sensei ni itte kudasai. Can you see this one? That is inside the box. So kyushitsu de kurasu no sensei ni ite kudasai. So that is also similar with kyushitsu de jibun no kurasu no sensei ni hanashimasu. That is why this is the correct answer. Okay? Number 27. So ice cream wa natsu ni taberu koto to totemo oishii desu ka? Watashi wa samui samui fuyu demo tokidoki tabemasu. So even if it is winter, you sometimes eat ice cream. Natsu wa mainichi taberu node cheese yasui kamene. Yasui mono shika kaimasen desu ga fuyu wa takai mono o kaimasu. Atatakai heya de ii ice cream o taberu no ga watashi no tanoshimi nano desu. So the question, the given choices for the problem are the following. So by the way, the problem is all about watashi no tanoshimi wa nan desu ka? That is the underlined phrase in the paragraph. Watashi no tanoshimi nano desu. So what is that watashi no tanoshimi means in the paragraph? So number one, let's have the choices. Fuyu ni atatakai heya de mainichi ice cream o taberu koto desu. It's incorrect. It was not mentioned in the paragraph that number one was done. Number three, natsu ni mainichi ice cream o taberu koto desu. Well, I think it wasn't mentioned as well in the paragraph. Natsu no natsu ni takai ice cream o taberu koto. It wasn't mentioned about takai because the only thing that was mentioned was yasui, not takai. So number four is X. Number four is incorrect. Number three is incorrect. Number one is incorrect as well. So the best answer here is fuyu ni atatakai heya de takai ice cream o taberu koto desu. That is, you can found that one here on the second sentence. So natsu yasumi kaimasen desu ga fuyu wa, so in the selection it was mentioned fuyu wa takai mono o kaimasu. That is why number two is the best answer for number 27. So when you do that one, it is a matter of context clue. Clue is the best in choosing the best answer for a JLPT and Yung reading problem like this. Number 28. So we have here announcement from Takada Sensei.
Hi,
そろそろ終わります。11時半。これは最後。はい。高田先生、そう、みそ、工場の森さんから denwa ga arimashita. So we have here the announcement. So if you're going to look the problem, so kono memo o yonde Takada sensei wa Morisan ni nani o shirase nakereba narimasen ka. So you go back to the problem and look for these choices if it is written. So kojo kengaku ni ikushito no ano ne. So the best answer here, because it was mentioned in the problem about ikushito, can you see at the bottom part? Ikushito no. This one. Oshite murau so, muraitai so. So that is in number three. It is found in number three. That's the answer for the problem 28. So kojo kengaku ni ikushito jikan to ikushito no su. So that is the correct answer for this problem. Hai, ijo desu.
Okay, thank you, Jose, for your presentation. Very interesting and a lot of questions for you.
Oh my God.
A lot of questions for you in the live chat or live comment in YouTube.
In Indonesia go, ne?
In English, in Japanese, Indonesia.
Oh my God.
But I will help you to
Hi, how
are you? Nasya sensei,
Hai Pak Ahmad, ini ada Sriyono Sang dan Hendra Sang yang mau bertanya langsung ke Jomar Sensei Dozo.
Hai.
Oke, silakan.
Dari Kara Sensei.
Hendra Sang.
Hai. Good afternoon, Hendra Sang.
Hai, semoga Jomar Sensei watashi wa Hendra desu. Ano, Itsumong Sitai desu.
Hai, dozo.
Watashi wa JLP teno shiken o uketa koto ga nai desu. Zehi kotoshi uketai desu. Ano, sosete watashi wa gokaku shitai desu. Gokaku, watashi wa gokaku dekiru yo ni ima online no jugyo seeking o ranking teams.
Ah, so desu.
Demo, demo amari doukai to chokkai muzukashii to omoimasu. Shitsumon wa kantan na kantan na yarikata ga arimasu ka?
Ah, so desu ne. Arimasu yo, kantan na.
JLPT shurutoki no N4 no bunpo wa zenbu dete imasu ka? Watashi nara ito desu.
Hai, arigato Hendra-san. Tashika ni N5 N4 wa N5 to N4 no testo wa sonna ni muzukashiku arimasen. It's not that difficult. The one that you can do, saisho, just get the clue. Clue wa daijoubu. De, after getting the clue in the problem for the bumpo, then you delete those not included in the sentence. You have the choice. We have four choices, and that from four choices, you use that one in a sentence. If you're going to use that one in a sentence, if it is not tadashi, it is fitadashi kunai, then you delete that one from your answer. So what is left in your choice is the answer for the problem. So that is the first thing that I do in yung LGLPT. The second one is find the nearest kotoba from the problem to the choices. Hey. It could be opposite, it could be negative, it could be positive, or it could be negative. For example, if the verb is negative, therefore you have to look for a word that makes the verb negative. For that case. So enyong no. If you're going to take enyong, the best that you can do if you are going to pass that one, go pakusuro yoni. Machigatta kotoba wa ekshite, delete shite, keshite, and then what remains in your choice is the best answer for the problem, for the mondai.
Ay, arimashita.
Ay, arigatou, Hendra.
Okay, Hendra, udah mengerti?
Hai.
Okay, lanjut mungkin ke Sriyono.
Hai. Suryono desu. Sumaseng, Jose Sensei, chotto shitsumon ga arimasu kara, chotto watashi nasha sensei to online de nihongo o benkyou shimasu. Demo chotto watashi pointo wa ichiban wari wa bumbu to doke des. Contoh ano doke no kantana yari kata do deska are tatebat saki ano sensei Tsumeshita monde wa ano nijuichi bangara nijuachi bang made watashi wa tabung genbu machikai masta.
Ah, so ka. Hai, hai, hai. Dokkai no koto desu ne, 21 kara. Jitsu wa dokkai wa chotto muzukashi kedo, watashi nara kotae toki taisetsu na kotoba dake o sagashite de machigatta koto wa keshite keshite nokotteiru koto dake nokotteiru kotoba dake tabun watashi wa final answer desu ne. So if you're going to read from the dokkai, dokkai is nagai desho, totemo nagai. Dokkai is totemo nagai, takusan kotoba ga hairu desu keredomo kotai wa hitotsu dake desho. There is only one answer for that dokkai. If you're going to answer the dokkai, go directly to the problem, not the dokkai itself. You read first the problem and then go to the dokkai. Find the answer in dokkai. That's my strategy. That's how I answer. That's my kotai kata when I answer dokkai. So I read the problem first. For example, nijuichi. Sorry ni dakara shikashi tatoeba. And then I go back to the problem. If which part of the choices in that problem is the best answer for the sentence. Take note, the clue is in the answer. And the clue can also be found in the dokkai. Okay? That is why if you're going to look at number 21, nijuichi bang, sori ni dakara tatoeba and shikashi. Clue there, let's go back to the dokkai, there is a verb dekimaseng. And if it is dekimaseng, negative, the best thing that you can use is a negative word, and that is shikashi. So that is how to answer dokkai. You just get the clue. Clue wa taisetsu desu. Kanji mo clue ni narimasu. Negative, positive.
Hai, Nastya sensei. Secara tidak langsung dilihat clue-nya, misalnya pertanyaannya teksnya kan panjang sekali. Nah, itu dilihat saja dari pertanyaannya, intinya itu dia mau tanyakan apa. Misalnya dia mau tanyakan kapan perginya, jadi kita langsung ke menuju ke paragraf yang menyatakan kapan perginya. Misalnya tanyanya tentang dengan siapa perginya, nah kita langsung cari kosakata yang inti kalimat yang ingin ditanyakan tersebut.
Honestly, I passed GLPT because of finding the clues.
Okay.
If you know how to find the clues, you will pass GLPT.
Permisi, Pak Mike, bisa diminta Pak Jose untuk pilih dari tiga penanya di kolom komentar yang untuk dapat souvenir. Toksu Niwa, Sanin, Erande.
Hai.
Hai, Sanin no Tetsumongo Erande. Sono Sanin no Hito wa, Sono Sanin wa souvenir o morau tame.
Ya.
Erande ne.
Hai.
Terima kasih Hendra dan Sriyono.
Hai.
Terima kasih Mas Hendra. Arigato.
Oke, silakan dipilih. Hai.
Langsung Jose apa saya milih?
Jose sensei yang pilih, kemudian Pak Mike yang bacakan.
Oke. So Jose, you have a lot of question in live comment in YouTube. In my list, maybe 10 or 12 questions. Yes. You can see the question, or I will read for you. I will choose three.
Onegai shimasu, please.
Yes, I will choose three for you. From the Cindy Kumala.
Hi.
I want to ask tips for quickly answering the Dokkei question without reading all the question about the story in order to save time.
Okay. Take note that if you're going to read everything in Dokkei, it would take time. Jikan ga kakaremasu. It would take time. Dokkei is very long and you have to understand all. So in JLPT, it is time-bounded, so you have to do it fast. Okay? So upon doing it, go directly to the problem first and look for the answer in the Dokkei. You don't have to read everything in the Dokkei. Because in the Dokkei, there are a lot of words, flowery words in the Dokkei itself. So those words are not necessary or important in the problem. So what you can do is saisho, go back to the problem, shitsumon o yonde, atowa dokkei o mite, and then find where can you see the problem itself from the dokkei, because the problem is coming from the dokkei itself. So that would be your technique to answer dokkei. You don't have to read everything in dokkei.
Okay. Is it clear? Yeah. The second question is from Chris Mandala. Konnichiwa, Jomar Sensei. I want to ask you about how to answer the question about feeling particle in Japanese. So we learning all particle in Japanese to answer GLPT.
For that note, answering a practical part of the Japanese, some problems are tricky, by the way. Tricky in a sense that there can be two or more answers in the questions. So again, what I am doing for that kind of problem, practical problem, is that I choose what is very near to the problem. So doing it, I erase those choices which are not near to the question. So if it is far, then I delete that one. So upon deletion, if I delete the three, only one would remain, and that one is for me the best answer, then I would choose that one as my answer. Take note, it is a matter of analysis or thinking. So if you know the meaning of the choices, then upon knowing it, you can simply delete some of those which are not related to the shitsumong, to the question.
So to be learning all of particle?
Yes,
of course, yeah. Okay, the last question. I will search. The last question is from the from
the from I can read here the answer. The statement of electric 2. Sumimasen, Jomar Sensei. Juroku bang no kotaite wa yong bang dato omoimasu. So yes, it is for me. I also believe that the answer is number 4, but in the given answer key by JLPT and Japan Foundation, they answered 1. So it is very difficult for us to somehow deal with it, because it is the answer from Japan Foundation and it is not our own answer. So in this case, the given answer is number 1, but I believe it is number 4. Electric 2, arigato gozaimasu for that. Again,
okay.
Yes. Number 28 as That's well. The answer is number 3. But upon the given answer key from Japan Foundation is the other way around. So for that case, it's difficult for us to change it. It's because they are the ones checking the JLPT and not us. Okay.
Okay, I think that's all the 3 questions from Cindy, from Chris, yes, and from Electric 2, I think, yeah.
Yes.
And can you explain again about the question with the stars?
Okay, the question with the stars. Okay. The question with the stars, this is the tricky part of JLPT. The past JLPT doesn't have a question like this, having the stars. So in this case, yeah, you have to choose what should be the best to insert on the star. The best word to insert on the star, to replace the star. Okay? Ichibang tadashi kotai. And then you insert that one to the star, to the hoshi. So in this case, what makes it very tricky is because most of the answers can be inserted in the star, but it is a matter of choosing the best as to what to be inserted in the star. Take note that the last word in the sentence and the first words in the sentence between the stars are the clue for the answers in the star. Okay.
The stars meaning of best answering or the
yes. What the is best answer for the best word that could be inserted or replace word. The okay, star. Okay.
Jadi untuk yang tadi pertanyaan bintang apa maksudnya yang dimaksud bintang tadi itu adalah yang jawaban yang paling benar di antara yang benar seperti itu. I think the best answer for the correct answer.
Yes.
And then about the can you share about the tips and trick for to answering for the long of paragraph? If you read the paragraph before or you answer the question.
Very good, Mr. Ahmad. So in that case, I read first the question, not the paragraph. Okay. I read first the question, and then I find those words in the question to the paragraph itself. Because if you're going to read the paragraph again, it's quite long. It's very long. It will take time. So go to the question, and from the question words, you've looked those words in the paragraph. That is a strategy. Okay, because upon doing it, it will not take you time to read everything.
Okay. Jadi kalau misalkan tadi yang tanya terkait dengan kapan jawab untuk pertanyaan yang paragraf panjang dulu atau jawab soal dulu. Jadi jawab soal dulu, baru membaca soalnya dulu, baru membaca paragrafnya. Oke. Okay. Once more, yeah. Jose. Once more. What's your strategy about the similar question?
Similar questions.
Yeah, similar question, and I think maybe we can the similar answer and the similar question in
In JLPT there is really question. In JLPT there is really a similar question and a similar answer. Okay, we cannot do anything about it in JLPT. But the best thing that you can do if there is similar question, so if there is a similar question in the same choices, you will have a similar answer for that. Okay, the same answer for the first or for the given problem that is similar. But if there are similar choices in a problem, so the best thing that you can do is to choose the best if the they are answer. Similar, yes, the best answer. Take note again and again. Even if it is correct for me, but the one that determines the correct answer is not me. It is the Japan Foundation. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much to Jose Sensei for your sharing, for your explaining about the GLPT. Thank you for your time.
Terima kasih.
Salamat. Okay. Terima kasih juga kepada Ibu Nasya atas waktunya terkait dengan sharing-sharing terkait dengan GLPT ini. Halo Ibu Nasya. I think she have trouble internet. I think.
Nasya Sensei is having a problem.
Yes, having a problem. Okay. I think it's all for the webinar GLPT in 19 July in 2020 in this afternoon. Thank you so much for your attention. Terima kasih semuanya teman-teman atas partisipasinya. Terima kasih atas atensinya. Terima kasih atas pertanyaan-pertanyaan yang menarik. Semoga bermanfaat untuk kita semua dan jangan lupa di dan juga di pandemic situation kita harus selalu menjaga stay safe for semuanya, untuk stay safe to all, stay safe to Jose, keep physical distancing, keep using mask, keep selalu mencuci tangan, hand washing, or using a hand sanitizer, or everything. Stay safe untuk semuanya. Mungkin ada yang ingin disampaikan, Bu Nasya, di terakhir.
Akhir ya. Oke, terima kasih banyak sudah bergabung di live streaming kali ini. Nanti kalau misalnya untuk pertanyaan di luar JLPT, nanti disesuaikan dengan webinarnya. Nah, insya Allah nanti dua minggu lagi itu ada kita payungnya dari UPN. Nah, ini nanti akan banyak tamunya, ada dari Filipina, dari Thailand, dari Rusia. Kita akan berangkat sahabat-sahabat kita Watashi no Tomodachi. Dan tolong disesuaikan dengan apa tema dari webinar, jadi kita pilih pertanyaannya, jadi enak gitu loh sharingnya, pas tepat di kesempatan yang tepat. Terima kasih banyak. Silakan Pak Mike kalau mau ditutup.
Okay, terima kasih. Maybe Jose, you can say the last.
Yes, thank you Nasya Sensei and Ahmad, Mr. Ahmad, for this opportunity, and thank you for the viewers, my Indonesian friends and from Philippines as well. If you have some questions soon, you just chat your sensei, Nasya Sensei, and I will attend to that, or you can also reach me via email or via Facebook. So I am so willing to help you to pass your GLPT soon. Hai, terima kasih, minasan.
Oke, arigato gozaimasu semuanya. Sampai ketemu lagi di webinar selanjutnya yang lebih menarik lagi. Oke, terima kasih semuanya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
From Philippines, I thank you.
Bye-bye.
Maraming selamat.
Selamat po.
Selamat po. Ah, arigato, Ahmad Sensei, Ahmad San.
Yes.
We've made it.
You can call me Mike.
Mike. Yes. English name, ne?
Yes.
The questions are very interesting, but we don't have any time to answer it.
Yes. Okay.
How many viewers we had?
I don't know.
How do we know how many viewers?
I think we can leave the...
Yes, how to leave? Yes. Okay, okay. Leave. I'll leave.
Okay, okay. Yes. Okay, see you.